going to show you each of the parts. And then at the end of the video, I'm going to give you a bunch of options for you more advanced players out there to make it even more interesting and more fun to play. What I want you to pay attention to is my second finger here and how it is playing the riff every single time. So I start with the G chord, my third finger, and I go up the arpeggio. And then we play the riff. That second finger. Now when we play that, we're gonna hold and switch our thumb to play that next measure, okay? Same idea when we're going from the D over F sharp to the C, we're using the second finger to move over. We play the C chord. Same idea, moving the second finger over to play the riff, back to the D over F sharp, okay? And then at the measure four, we have this rising phrase sounding like this. And that's just the rising phrase to get back into we play the whole thing in context. I'm just gonna play the first eight measures slowly. Remember, measures 5 through 8, just repeat measures 1 through 4, except that at measure 5, we start with this note on the G, on top of the G. 3, 4. That's our intro slash main riff. That's the main riff of this song. Let's move into the verse. So it'll sound like this, just with the chords and melody. G, D of F sharp, C, D of F sharp again. If you take a look at the chord diagrams above the tab, it shows you a really important left-hand fingering that I suggest to follow every single time. Because once you can just kind of play the chord, and if you're following the grip, then you can start filling in with what we call these rhythm fills. And it's just what we're doing here is playing arpeggio. Again, it's arpeggio picking with the chord melody. So putting that all together will sound like this. Fill, melody, fill. Okay, so see the idea? We're just filling that it. Filling in that extra space with arpeggios. Now, it doesn't really matter which notes you hit from the arpeggio. You could fill it in with lower notes like this. As long as you're holding the chord, it's going to be harmonized correctly. And then you can choose what harmony you want to play. Or you could just copy the one that I have here. So again, back to measure 11. We'll start with C. Melody note. Okay. That time I added what we call a walk-up. We'll talk about that later towards the end of the video. Now measures 13 through 16 are exactly the same as measures 9 through 12. So let's just hear 13 through 16 going into the next section, which is the chorus. Sounds like this. 2, 3, 4. That brings us into the chorus. Same idea, make sure you're following the chord grips. We're playing the melody and filling in with arpeggios. So this is what the chorus sounds like very slowly. 2, 3, 4, C.
Thank you.
back to the riff. Okay, so the chorus is only a 6-measure phrase, which is a little bit unusual. A couple of the extra things that I want to point out here is you can add harmony like anytime you want. So for example, like on the, I'm adding, the melody just goes, right? And I'm adding, basically anytime, as long as you're holding the right chord with your left hand and following the chord grips I have in the diagrams, you can add any melody note, which is the highest note always, and any string under it will harmonize with it correctly. So instead of just going, oh, 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 three, two, holding the chord, we can go, okay. You also see that we're doing that just to give it a little harmony in measure 19. Okay. And then it just goes back to your main riff when you play it. You can kind of give it a little slow down there towards the end just to let your audience know that you're finishing. I think this is a really great arrangement as it is, and it's especially good for beginners, but as promised, we're going to talk about some options to make it cooler. The first option we're going to talk about is making the main riff sound more authentic to the original. So we've made the main riff down here in the open position, right? It's the same notes as the real riff, but we all know that he plays it kind of up here. Now we can't very easily reach this G and do this. So what is our option? We can also do it here. Now you can give that with a bend, but bends are really hard on the acoustic. So what I recommend is actually to do a slide. Play the arpeggio here with any finger. Okay, and then play that phrase. And then what I recommend actually is to do it as kind of a variation. Play the low part the first time. But then when you get to the repeat, play the extension. You can take it all the way up to the top there if you like. For some of you, you might be wondering, what about the bridge part? Yeah, that's our other option that we can add. So the bridge part comes in after the chorus, but before the riff comes in. So it'll sound like this. Just add this to your arrangement when you're ready. Back to the riff, the kind of intro part. Okay, so use that for your reference. If you want to add the bridge, then you can make this song a lot longer. Number three, we can add those walk-ups that we talked about from the beginning. So the walk-ups work best in measure 12 and measure 16, and then on any times you're repeating those sections. So it's really simple. Just before we go to that G, we're going to do a walk up to G, which is always the same. We go open, two, three. Okay. Same idea in measure 16, except this time we're walking up to C going into the chorus. That'll sound like this. So that time we did a walk up to C, there's the note C, and we go 0, 2, 3 on the A string, walk up to C. Finally, this option is going to be for some advanced players really wanting to arrange this and make it their own. A lot of fingerstyle players will play in different and weird open tunings. And so I thought about a couple options. And the one that seems the best to me is to retune the low two strings down to C and then G, and then leave the rest of the strings the same. Let me show you how that works and why it would be beneficial. So I'm switching guitars here so I can use my thicker strings. Okay, now this isn't a tuning I've ever really, this isn't a common tuning. This is kind of one I just made up, and I made it up based on the need to do certain things. It's in the key of G, so this note G comes up a lot. So it made perfect sense to tune the A string down to G. Okay, that way we can start the piece off. Okay, now getting this note down to C, I chose that because we have a C chord coming up later, and we can get our low string all the way down to C without too much effort. But the coolest part is that it leaves our D note here with our thumb, which gives us our exact same grip that we had been working on from before. So instead of just playing the D over F sharp, we're still going to be kind of thinking about it as like D over F sharp, but this time this note will now be D. Okay, so the whole thing might sound something like this. And the other cool part about that is now if we have an open string, those riffs that we're not able to play because we couldn't make the big reach, now we can play those. So now that we have some of those open strings, it opens up some options for doing, you know, bends while we still have that note playing. Right? It gives you some more creative freedom up the neck since you aren't restricted to those low bass notes that are down here. I hope that makes sense and just gives you something to play around with. I had a lot of fun teaching this one. I think this one's going to help you out a lot if you kind of go through the steps that we talked about. And this is a really fun performance piece to play. Everybody recognizes this song. So, you know, have fun with this. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one.